Good morning. This is Samuel with Truth and Reason Ministry. And in this video, I want to talk about the strangest place I've ever tried to evangelize, or the strangest place I've ever tried to talk to someone about Jesus Christ. And I believe that this account illustrates a very important point that many of us struggle with, including me, which is why I'm making these videos. I do make these videos not just for you, but I also make them for me, for encouragement, but I believe there'll be an encouragement for many people who watch. And this goes back to one summer when I was in college. I was an intern with a ministry, and I remember that we'd had some downtime over the weekend, and we had gone to a park that had a spring. And I remember being at the park, just sort of walking around, and all of a sudden I just sort of felt this burden inside, like, oh man, I want to share the gospel with someone. Who can I share with? And I'm just looking for any opportunity. But as I'm looking around, I just see people who are, they look really busy. They're having fun with their friends, with their family, or they're grilling out, or they're swimming. And I just really didn't see an opportunity to share my faith. And at this point, I'm feeling like the prophet Jeremiah. If some of you are familiar in Jeremiah chapter 20, he's being mocked by the people because he keeps preaching the word of God. And he says in Jeremiah chapter 20, verse 9, that his word, or God's word, is in his heart like a fire. And he's growing weary of holding it in. And this is what I was feeling like. I was feeling weary of holding in the gospel. It was like holy heartburn. So I felt like Jeremiah at that moment. I'm like, man, I got to share with someone. What am I going to do? And lo and behold, I make my way into the men's bathroom. And I don't know why I went to the men's bathroom. I make my way into the men's bathroom. And I hear a guy in a stall, and he's obviously just gotten done using the restroom, and he's coming out, and he's buckling his belt. And suddenly, I just blurted out. I said, excuse me, sir, I have a question for you. Are you going to heaven? And the guy looked surprised. He looked at me, and his eyes were kind of open like this. He was surprised. And he wasn't surprised for why I thought he would be surprised for, but he was actually surprised because I might not have known if I was going to heaven or not. He was surprised that someone didn't know where they were spending eternity. He says, yes, I'm going to heaven. Aren't you? And I said, yes, sir, I am going to heaven. But I say all that to say this, that in many ways, we're not ready with the gospel. And God had put it on my heart to be ready at that moment to share. And that may have been kind of a crude time or a time that was inappropriate to share. But the point is, we always need to be ready with the gospel in season and out of season. This isn't just for ministers, but this is for us who have the gospel of God inside of us, in our heads, in our mouths, in our hearts, and we need to be ready to share. I think of what the Apostle Paul says in Ephesians chapter 6, verses 14 and 15. He says, stand firm and having your feet shod with the preparation of the gospel of peace. And one of the struggles that I believe that we have is that we're not prepared. We don't have our gospel shoes on as we ought to have our gospel shoes on. And we're missing opportunities. Oh no, I'm not ready. Oh no, I'm doing something right now. Oh no, that person looks busy. Oh no, this is gonna be awkward. And we don't have the gospel ready on our lips, and therefore we're missing opportunities. And I want to challenge you, have your gospel shoes on. Have your feet shod with the preparation of the gospel of peace. Learn a way of sharing the gospel to the point so that it would be natural to you. And I want to close with this. A very convicting scripture for me in Ecclesiastes chapter 11. And this encourages me very much. And I hope it encourages you. Flipping to chapter 11. Ecclesiastes 11, verse 4. And he says, Solomon says, he who watches the wind will not sow, and he who looks at the clouds will not reap. And I know that I'm an introvert, so this is a struggle of mine. I'm always constantly in myself. I'm in my own head. I'm constantly thinking, okay, is this the right time? Should I do it here? Is it going to be awkward? Am I scared? So I find myself missing opportunities to share the gospel. However, here he says, he who watches the wind will not sow, and he who looks at the clouds will not reap. And he's saying here that the farmer who's looking for those perfect conditions, or when the time seems right, or when he feels right, he's going to miss the opportunity to sow the seed. And as Christians, and as a church, I feel like a lot of times we don't think it's the right time. So we're missing opportunities to sow the seed of the gospel and to see it grow. And I want to challenge you today. Be ready. Pray, God, where can I sow the gospel? And sow it. Open your mouth. And you may think, oh man, this is going to fail. This person is going to get mad. They're going to get angry. But folks, it is better to share the gospel in an awkward situation where there's a seemingly bad result than not share the gospel at all. Because God can use a bad result. God can use an awkward result. But what he can't use is a seed that's not there, that hasn't been planted, that hasn't been thrown out. God's not going to use anything that's not there. So I want to encourage you, always be ready. Have a great day. Bye-bye.